Hello guys and welcome to Walking Project. My name is Tony and this is going to be the shortest and the most accurate review of the ASUS ROG phone you're gonna see on YouTube. Now I'm gonna stick directly to my Walking Spectrum scoring system. I've tested about 100 phones, I've got 10 different categories and I'm gonna give it a rating from 1 to 6 on each one of those individual categories. So let's waste no more time and let's get started. The first category is design and build quality. The phone is absolutely built like a tank, but it's way too big and way too heavy, over 250 grams, guys. So it's definitely not for everyone. The LED programmable logo is quite cool at the back of the phone, as well as this special vent over here and the programmable air trigger hardware buttons, which can be remapped to any button on the screen while gaming. So I'm gonna give it 4 out of 5 here. The next category is security. The under the screen fingerprint reader works well unless your hands are wet. The face unlock is not too shabby either, so I'm gonna give it 4 out of 5. Moving on to battery life, 6000 mAh of battery, which unfortunately recharges for 2.5 hours. The screen on time is between 6 and 9 hours, depending on your usage. Not brilliant, but better than most phones out there, so 4 out of 5. The screen is 6.6 inch, the first in the world AMOLED screen with 120 Hz refresh rate. Unfortunately, there is some noise issues with the screen while on low brightness and while you're watching a gray or purple picture. You can see some grain on the screen, so it's not the very best high quality they could have used, and it's just 1080p, so I'm gonna give it 4 out of 5. Next category is speakers, and I'm happy to report that you've got the loudest speakers of any phone, guys. Two stereo speakers with a dedicated amplifier for each one of them. Absolutely top level of stereo separation and overall loudness. Plus you've got special outdoor mode which boosts the mids and the highs, so you can hear even better in loud environment. So 6 out of 5 over here. The same thing goes for the 3.5 mm jack. Absolutely the loudest one by far of any phone in the market right now. Plus highly customizable equalizer profiles, so 6 out of 5 easily. Next category is performance, and it's absolutely flawless, guys. This is the chart-topping phone in AnTuTu, as well as according to my own testing, 120 Hz plus the Snapdragon 855 plus, you're not gonna have a problem with any game. Plus you've got this extra vent over here where the heat escapes, so no throttling and no overheating whatsoever. 6 out of 5 straight away. Unfortunately, on the software side, things are different. I'm gonna give it 4 out of 5, simply because if you buy the international version, you're sorted, but it's way too expensive. So you're gonna end up with the Chinese version and you're gonna flash the worldwide unlocked ROM on it, which means no OTA updates, which means that you are risking of breaking your phone, updating your phone manually, or you're forever stuck with the ROM that it's shipped from the Chinese to your house, so no updates. That's why 4 out of 5. In the camera department, 24 megapixel selfie camera, no 4K, 1080p, has excellent stabilization, and overall the pictures are quite good, so 4 out of 5. And 4 out of 5 for the main cameras as well. The 48 megapixel camera is essentially a 12 megapixel camera. The 13 megapixel super wide angle camera does an excellent job and there is almost no distortion whatsoever. In low light, both of the cameras are not very good. Nighttime pictures are not very good as well, and they're actually terrible on the wide angle camera. The zoom is terrible, as well as the macro. But if you install the Google camera application, it improves the image quality quite a bit, so you're gonna get a crazy good HDR pictures of this camera. At the end of the day, is the Sony IMX586 or whatever the sensor is, pretty much top of the range sensor, so you can experiment with that. So again, 4 out of 5. So what is the overall Walking Spectrum score? Is 46 out of 50, which is pretty much the best phone according to my own, you know, testing. However, is it my favorite phone? No, it is not. It is the Huawei Mate 20 Pro, as well as the Oppo Find X somewhere on my desk over here. But if you're heavy on gaming, this is the phone to get. However, don't pay the full price, $900 in the US, £830 here in the UK. That's absolutely crazy. You shouldn't spend that much on this phone. Instead, go to GearBest. I'm gonna leave a link in the description down below. 420 quid, this is the phone to get, guys. Of course, you're gonna have to live with the firmware that the Chinese are going to install. Don't worry, they're gonna flash the unlocked international version, but in order to be updated, you're gonna have to go to XDA, do a little bit of reading, and risk of breaking your device, of course. So that's the sacrifice you're gonna make. Thank you very much for watching, and let me know whether this experimental format works for you. Of course, if you wanna watch my full 20-minute review, you can do so. I'm gonna leave a bunch of links in the description down below, including a sound test, a camera test, an unboxing, a game test, and yeah, the full review. So 5 videos in total for this phone, guys. Let me know again, do you like this format? Thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next one.